Damn straight. If I take a loss, I'm bouncing back. I gotta get this game. When you on your back, you gotta go, nigga. You never wait. Pull off on my team, little nigga. Carry your own way. Blinded by your love, just trying to find my soulmate. Open up your arms, invite me to them heaven gates. Bitchin' by my cheese, cheddar cheese. I'll never wait. Yeah, I'll never wait. Yeah. We gon' shine till it's our time, yeah, yeah. We fall down, I'ma stack and grind until we fall down. Yeah. If you want some pressure, little nigga, just say it's pressure. He move with a weapon, he special, he always steppin'. Slash, that's my brother, he slash, he so splashy too. Shy V1K, he never folded, that's my brother too. That's my brother, that's my Woody and my Rada too. I don't really fuck with niggas, but nigga, I fuck with you. But nigga, I fuck with you. Paint the sky red, yeah, for all my niggas dead. Long live me, long live me, gotta get this guap instead. Gotta get this guap instead. One day we gon' shine, yeah, we gon' shine. Till it's our time, yeah, yeah, we ball now. Yeah, we ball now.
Going to my, you know, freshman year, it was more so a learning experience, you know, learning curve for me, you know. Had to adapt to a more atmosphere where I'm on my own sometimes. New teammates, it's seniors, juniors, you know, freshmen. So it was more so me just going in there and just trying to make a name for myself, you know. Freshman year, it was more so me getting my feet wet early. And then going into my sophomore year, it was just like, it was like high school for real. It was just, you know, it was curtains, just lights off, honestly. I'm comfortable out there, my feet wet, you know. Made a name for myself worldwide. So it's like, you know, just going into sophomore season, it was just, you know, I'm dominating. Like, I'm that dude, basically. I wanted to go out there and let them know, like, I'm that killer out here. And I'm the one that you got to go against. You're going to have a long night. So, you know, that's how I took my sophomore season, for sure. That ride wave, man, that gave me through my days, you know. It's just like he touched your soul a little bit different, you know. And then just coming from where we come from Wilmington, you know, it's like it's hard sometimes, you know. You got a single parent home, you know father's not in our lives. So it's just like what he preaching, when he rapping and what he's singing, it's just like it hits you so different when you can relate to him. So I mean, some people don't like my boy because he always depressed and sad, but I mean, sometimes it's not for everybody. He said it in the song, you feel me? So it's like, you know, it's the ones who can relate to him and who, the ones, you know, who accept me for who he is and, you know, just listen to him all the time. So it's definitely a great, you know, feeling just to relate to somebody in the rap industry, for sure. Honestly, really don't know where I would be without them. Honestly, you know, as I always say, growing up as a kid in Wilmington, you just finding your way, honestly. You know, kids, they either fade to the hoops or a different sport, or they fell to the streets, honestly. So, you know, just them being around me and helping me and guiding me to, you know, to see bigger things, you know, as a young teenager, as a kid. It's just like, it just showed the type of person they are and the type of value they have in themselves. And, you know, they was kids once, you know, they didn't know where to go, honestly. They had older people who got them as well to be the person they are today. So, you know, just them just helping me each and every way they can and could, honestly, that meant so much to me. You know, just growing up, single parent household, you know, my mom, she held it down also, but, you know, really never had a father figure in my life. So they stepped in and just tried to play that big brother role for me, you know. So it just, like, that means so much to me, because I got a pure heart. And, you know, the people around me, I always just want to, you know, whatever I can do for them, whether it's love, giving them joy, you know. Or you just being in here and just grinding hard for him, because, you know, we in here 9:30 at night all the way to like 11:30, 11:45. He don't got to be doing that, you know. He got a kid, he got kids, he got nephews, he got nieces, you know. He could be spending that time with them. So it just means so much to me, you know, he taking his time out of his day and trying to make me become a better, help me become a better basketball player and help me in any way he can, honestly. So it just means so much to, you know, to me, just having, you know, Spoons, whether it's Big AJ, whether it's Lamar, whether it's, you know, one of my, either my coaches, you know, or like, just anybody who has helped me just to become the man I am today. It just, it means so much to me, you know, it's just like, you know, sky's the limit for me, for sure. You know, sky's the limit for them as well. You know, I'm just in their corner as well. They in my corner for me, for sure. So, that's it.
All right, so
Mar is like a, you know, I was just crazy because, you know, as when I was a, like a little younger, you know, growing up, I was around, you know, Big AJ, and he helped me, you know, do a lot, Spoons, and then Mar had came in the picture, you know, around my, I don't even know what year it was. I was just so little, you know, just like he was just, yeah, he just welcomed me with open arms, you know. He came from the north side of Wilmington. You know, same kind of background as me, so I related to him actually very quickly. So just knowing, you know, him and just knowing for who he is, you know, he always keep it real. He gonna tell you what you don't want to hear, and that's what you need in life so you can grow. I've been growing ever since I was, you know, little and different, you know, attributes, you know, whether it's maturing, he done helped me mature, you know. He done been there for me, you know, late nights, you know, where I'm probably down and out, or I need someone to talk to, you know, he answering the phone. He's keeping it real with me, you know, after a bad game, he telling me what I had to do, what I did wrong, what I did good. So, you know, he's just like a big brother to me. Definitely, Mar is just like, you know, it's so hard to describe him because he comes in with so much love and tough love that you need that's not out here in the world now. So, you know, I'm just blessed to have him around in my circle for sure.
Yep. Loader game. Good. Next side. Loader. Two more. Good, Ben. Good. Get in there. Give me two.
You just like really keeping them sharp. Some stuff they already, you know what I mean, they already got in them. Of course, you can add little stuff to their game, but at the same time, you got to allow a player to be creative in his own way. You know what I mean? Every player doesn't play the same, of course. So, you know, like, that's one of the biggest things about Busy, for real. Like, he has his own, you know, his own flavor to the game. You know what I mean?
I would say it was both ways for it. It really depends on like the grade level I was in, you know. I was always a competitive kid growing up. I always wanted to compete no matter who you was. I always grew up, you know, I didn't care about rankings. I cared about, you know, me grinding in the gym and just showing the world who I am and showing them that I'm the best, you know. So it's just like, just me, honestly, you know, I just got a different level of mentality, honestly. It's like a tight ball, so you just want it so bad, you don't care about what anybody else got to say, honestly. So it's just like, you know, growing up, I just always wanted to like show different people that I'm at, for sure.
Name who, nigga? Just side steps, for real. You know what I mean? Step backs, all that. Just cause separation. All right? Get away from me.
Seriously. another level. Kicking another gear. Another gear.
Five. Like, being in the gym with each other, it's you know, we brothers, but we competing, like, we don't know each other, you feel me? Like, talking trash, you feel me? That's how we all came up, how we all elevated, honestly. Since we was younger, we always been talking trash to each other, you know, ready to fight on the court, all that, but it's, at the end of the day, we brothers, you feel me? So that, I feel as though that built a lot of character in us, it built toughness, you know, and it built, you know, a lot of drive in us, and just the will to win, and the will to compete, because everybody don't got that competitiveness or your heart, honestly. So I feel as though just, you know, the traces is just like, I just feel we just different, for sure.
Wait around for it. Oh, this is starting. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. rare form. I mean, that hack.
I'm gonna give you a pass too.
Yep, I know. Even if you give me a bad pass, you work on them too. Moolah. Oh!
I mean, six.
How many you missed?
Probably like five or six. Moss at five. 15 for 20.
Shot. Shot bar.
It's exciting, honestly, just being able to, you know, see my brothers on TV after me or before me. It's like we all come from, like, you feel me, either the state of Delaware, you know? And it's just like being able to see them on TV, that's not normal for us. So it's like even it hit home to everybody, honestly, like just seeing, you know, players that come up from Delaware, you know, because it's not a lot of us that's at D1 schools right now. It's players, you know, got to take different routes to even get to that stage and that level to play D1 even on national TV. So it's like, honestly, it just feels great, and you just feel excited. I have my boy playing at, you feel me, 9:30 or 7:30. I'm locked in, I'm ordering pizza and wings, you feel me? I'm gonna watch my boy, he's gonna go off, you feel me? So it's just like, it's exciting. Even if he don't go off, it's just the fact that it's the principal, he on TV, and it's just rare to see that, you know, honestly. So I just, you know, I salute that for sure, and it's just like, I always look forward to, you know, watching my brother on TV. It just added another, like, you know, somebody else in the gym has the same drive as you, it make you want to go harder, and, you know, it be pushing each other, so it make you
it make you take that rep extra serious, or you just pushing each other every rep to get better. And it's just like, you know, sometimes when you're in the gym by yourself, you know, you can have them thoughts or that rep sometimes where it's like, ah, but you know, when you're in the gym with a brother or something, it's like, you know, not saying me though, but you know, I take almost every rep if I'm serious. But you know, just having somebody like Haas in the gym with you, it make you just, you know, just keep that competitive drive up for sure.
Who's more so like, yo, what's going on? Shit, second day, Bubba, it was like, you know, it was starting to come alive a little bit. It was more so, you know, I was starting to see Eric, Mikey, I saw AJ Hogarth from Michigan State, so it's like, you know, who's more so, I've seen my brothers from a long time ago, so it's good to reunite with them, and it was just like, damn, we in a bubble, but it make you like, all right, I can see them on a daily basis, so now it's not going to be as much as like, all right, this it's not that, you know what everybody saying is. So it was more so coming along, but then, you know, when people start playing, all the teams start, you know, leaving the bubble and stuff. I didn't get to experience that because we had left early, but like just hearing from like Eric and stuff like that, he just said like, on the days was going by, teams was losing, and the bubble was just getting dry, you didn't see nobody no more, so it was just like, you know, just hearing from his experiences, it sounded like, you know, it started getting even like more boring, and it's more so like a mind thing. So,
how did it feel to have to leave early like that before you even had a chance to really show everybody what's going on?
Gift and a curse, you know. You never know what God got planned for you down the line. So, I mean, but it's also a curse because you know, you wanted to. I don't want to say it's a curse, but it's just like a dual moment where you just like, you know, you could have, you know, like, produced out there or made an impact, you know, out there with your team. So it's like that just being taken away from you is like heartbroken, and you just wish for that moment your whole life. Watching March Madness, watching like the dudes like Trey Burke and all of them hitting big shots. I've been watching Michigan for a long time, and him at Michigan. So it's just like, just watching him hitting them shots is like, wow, like, that's gonna be me one day. And you know, I'm just getting pumped up day-to-day basis in the bubble, just waiting for that moment. It's just like, it's taken away from him so fast. So it was a heartbroken moment, but it's just like, you know, you never know what God got planned for you, so it's like, you know, you just never question him. So I just move along and just enjoy my journey for sure.
Like that movement, Hoss. You're moving. Talk to me.
There.
Gotcha. Yep. 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 You're shooting out from here.
All right, first block.
Boom. You're getting here, here, shot, getting another one shot. So you're already coming to this line. All right, you're getting two quick ones. Get right back, shoot back out. All right, you got 20. Yeah, yeah.
So it's 20 me first and then
20. I need you quick. I need you going. As soon as he get it. Now right back. Exactly. Now right back. Thank you. Right back. Turn up. Good. Good touch. Dude, he's right, capable of doing that. I know what you're saying.
What I want to say.
He's capable of doing that. But one thing I had to explain to them, all of them are very different.
Hell yeah.
And they all got their own type of ways.
That's
EA
the crazy
is big,
part, though. Like, it really is all different, though.
I'm going to just say this.
Really gonna look at that. Go mode, though.
Hey, look, this is all I'm going to say. When it's a couple possessions, but y'all don't score, dog.
Yeah.
You got like, I'm the best player.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
He started doing that, though.
I'm just saying, like, he really turned him. Like, put it like this, dog. So much is given, much is expected.
I didn't mean that.
Yeah.
When it's time to turn that shit on, bro, Glow, turn that shit on, bro.
Put it like, he turns that shit on. I want him to start Jack. I want him to start
Jack. He's not that.
He can pass the shit out the ball.
Yeah, he's not that. Put it like this. He's really a point guard. Right, he don't do that.
It was more so about the team. So the team needed, like, someone to put more pressure on the defense.
I put a perfect example right in the runs, right? He always just got this mentality. They on the same team. He trying to get Busy involved because he's like, man, Biz can score the fuck out of the ball. He not think, like, he could go score.
Yeah,
but he's just looking like, he trying to get everybody else, like, I'm getting everybody else involved. Like, that's just him.
And me, I'm like, yo, why you in slow motion? What are you doing? We lost. I go to the loser court. He's still in slow motion. I'm like, bro, like, what are you doing, bro? So, you know me, I'm taking shit in my own hand. We back on the main court. I'm taking, I ain't losing no more, bro. I don't know what type of time you on.
I already know what you were saying.
Don't you know how, like, you're running the set? So this is, I watched it. When I called you, though, it was because I was watching something, like, happen throughout the game. So he's coming down court. Don't you know when you just even take one dribble in and attack off the initial, like, off the initial pass, like, say, boom, you go like this, boom, and that just sucks in the defense. It'll be little stuff like that where, like, basically passing it, and then Maryland just keeps passing around the perimeter, so they're not getting any type of, like, penetration because those dudes can't dribble. Dudes can't dribble, bro. They cannot create their own shot. So essentially, they're just swinging around the perimeter because he's not making that initial drive just to boom, initiate the offense and get a flow going. Those guys aren't like that. See, they, you know what I mean? That's what,
like, then, they're like, not, boom, like, on the perimeter,